Hi, my name is Jason Torres, and I'm a graduate student in the laboratory of Dr. Nancy Cox at the University of Chicago, where we study the genetics of complex diseases. These are diseases that are very common, that a lot of people in our families have, but aren't really that easy to pick apart. And so what we try to do is use computational and statistic methods to tease apart that genetic infrastructure or architecture to better find out what's going on and give us some ideas for developing new exciting treatments. I'm a graduate student, and my focus right now is on type 2 diabetes, where I want to understand what are the major drivers for susceptibility to type 2 diabetes, ideally in Latino populations. Mexican Americans and other Latino populations have very high prevalences of type 2 diabetes in the U.S., but as it stands now, there haven't been that many studies, and so I use data sets representing Mexican Americans and a population from Mexico City to understand which variants are really the key ones that are driving susceptibility to these populations. So the reason I came up to Chicago was because the specific questions I was really interested in, some of the best researchers in that area are studying here. And so one thing that I found to be challenging was moving away from my family, which I was very close with, to commit myself to understanding this type of question better, to research it more deeply with better training, I guess. I think what really got me to consider science was that when I was in college, I was in a punk band, and I've actually been playing in punk bands since I was 15, and I found out that a lot of my favorite bands had members that were doing science. So I was like, you know, wow, what's going on here? And if you think about it, you would be kind of, you wouldn't really think that science and punk rock have a lot in common. But it turns out that there are some common threads that I've really come to appreciate kind of from both sides. And in punk rock and science, you have to be creative to address problems from a different perspective. What's really engaging about being in lab is that you're constantly being exposed to new problems, and you need to think carefully about how to attack those problems. But when you do, you feel, of course, fulfilled that, hey, I learned something. But one of the most challenging things about doing research is that things don't always work out the way you'd like them to, and that actually is more of the norm than the exception. But part of the excitement about science is those moments when things work out. You finally get results that are genuine, that are real results, and are interesting results. And then you realize that you're the first person in the history of humanity that's ever discovered this little fact about the universe. So that kind of makes it worth it, for the most part. So science always benefits from having multiple people engaged on a problem. In fact, science is a process, and the more people working on a problem, the faster we can get to a solution. And students from different backgrounds have different perspectives that they can bring into science and, you know, address certain issues that are under-addressed and really help to understand areas of biology and health and disease that haven't been as well focused. A lot of diseases have different prevalences and susceptibilities in different populations, and individuals who are from these populations really have more at stake, you can say, in understanding this. Most of the genetic studies that have been done to date focus on Europeans and European Americans, but the vast majority of the planet is comprised of people from different genetic compositions and different ancestries and different evolutionary histories. And so the more people who are engaged in trying to find basis for disease, the more interesting biology we'll discover.